Welcome to Atlanta, where the players play, and we ride on them things like every day. Big beats hit the streets, see gangsters roaming, and parties don't stop till 8 in the morning.
And welcome to the Dirty South.
I ain't never heard none of
you.
Well,
playing service or prior?
That's it.
Action. What's up, everybody? You are listening to Currently Mikey with Rock on WTT Radio. What's going on, Rock?
What's going on, Mikey?
How you been, man?
I've been good, yo. It's been a lot going on, you know.
Too much going on. We got some topics to talk about today. You know that, right?
We really do.
What's up, y'all? It's your boy, Rock. The only, the official Rock. I'm from Hickory, North Carolina. I moved to Atlanta about a year ago. I'm known for acting. Y'all see me on About Him. Y'all see me on House Boys. Y'all see me on The Girls. Y'all see me on Greenleaf. Y'all see me on Star. Just to name a few.
Like, first of all, what's going on with the sexual assault that's going on in Hollywood?
Man, I don't know. And you know, it's kind of crazy because this industry, the acting world, even doing rep series and stuff, you always deal with people higher that want to sleep with you and be like, oh, if you're not gonna sleep with me, I'm not gonna give you that spot. Like, it's real life.
Currently, I'm on a radio show called Currently Mikey with Rock. It's every Tuesday. We talk about different types of things, gay stuff, straight stuff. We have celebrities on every week from 7 to 9 on WTT Radio.
Wait a minute, so you've been in a situation where somebody might have tried to get you to get on your back for a role?
You know, I've been in a situation or two.
Yeah. Well, I hope you told them no. It's just, for me, when I hear stuff like that, I'm just like, well, what does the talent come in? What does the real work come in? Are people just screwing their way to the top?
Sadly, some people are. Like, some people get the roles that they get because of what they can do and what they do for people. And that's, honestly, if there were entertainers or artists that was honest about that, that's why you see so many movies or so many series where it's not real talent going on. It's,
really?
It's people that's like, well, I'm not going to talk about
that. Well, we're not going to talk about that. All I'm going to say is that I just see a lot of situations where it's a lot of directors, producers, and maybe big writers that are taking advantage of actors and actresses and stuff. And even here in Atlanta, you know, I hear a few things. I know of a few cases and stuff, but I just figure it's the Atlanta way, you know?
See, it's weird because even now, people have different ways of coming up. People have a different ways of chasing their dreams or chasing their passions, and some people have to stoop down, and that's sad. Some people are so gullible and vulnerable that they decide to, well, not decide, but they just feel like they don't have another choice, they don't have another option but to sleep with this one person just so I can get to where I need to go.
What made me get on the radio show was my friend Mikey, Michael Fanning, who is a PR, and he's also a publicist for HeyMikeyATL.com. He actually reached out to me and was like, yo, we can put our connections together and do this. And it was like he came with a business plan, so I looked at it in the business aspect. But I love it. I get to be myself. I get to talk to people.
I know you've been looking for a place for a while now. How's that like turning out for you?
You know, I'm so excited because I finally found, I think, my home away from home. Because, you know, home is for me is from North Carolina.
Oh.
But, yeah, I found this really, really nice apartment in Midtown, the heart of Atlanta. And I'm actually planning a housewarming party, but you know, I'm gonna talk about it. Yeah, of course you're gonna be there, but
okay.
I'm gonna talk about it a little bit more after we get some songs in. So y'all make sure y'all tune into WTT Radio, download the app, share it with your friends. We'll be right back after this.
That's right.
Hold on, give me a second.
Hotline, buddy.
Hello? Yo, what's going on, man? Oh, no, that's cool. I told you, like, we can hang out.
I had met a young man through social media, and he was wanting to hang out with me. So I was like, oh, wouldn't it be so nice if I just say, come to the party with me?
No, actually, I heard about this party that's about to go down, and I was like, that'd be a good time for us to meet, you know, introduce you to my friends. Yeah. No, they all cool. My best friend be there. So yeah, it'd be cool. Be real chill. That sounds good? Right. All right, yo.
I see you, what?
Timmy Lee. I'm from New Orleans, Louisiana, and I'm known to be a fashion designer. I come on the scene, slay all the girls. Nobody ever looks better than me. My style is very everywhere. I don't have like a certain style. I'm like, when I wake up and I feel like Chinese, I'm gonna come outside looking like Chinese fish. If I feel like rock star, I'm gonna put on rock star clothes. Whatever I feel, that's how I'm coming outside. I don't limit myself to a style. What's going on, my child?
My name is Darian. I'm from, well, I was born in North Carolina, but I moved to Georgia, so I've been here for quite a years. I'm most known for, I guess I'm a, could say a socialite on Instagram or whatever. People most know me for coming out as gay, because I guess I look, I don't know. But so people, I've gained like a real big fan base last year because I came out and there was a lot of people, you know, were so shocked to me.
What you doing?
My child, Thorn Jane. Got a little thorn going on. Little shit, child. What you got going on?
I don't know. Sitting here in these schools.
What's up?
What's up?
Darren is my gay child. We met last year for New Year's. He was hanging like with this foolish crowd of people, and I just seen like so much of me in him, so I was just like, I should take him up under my wing. So that's what I did. I made him my child. It's about to be a year that he's been my child, and it's amazing. I mean, Darian is like hard-headed as hell. He, oh Jesus, got so many problems, but I mean, hey, I gotta deal with it. I'm a gay parent.
So what's going on with this show?
Nothing, girl. You know I'm supposed to be having my show or whatnot, child, but right now I'm just throwing in all this stuff ready or whatever. This shit working my nerves, getting on my last nerves. Not full connection.
How many more pieces you
gotta
do?
Oh, there we go. I wanna do 15 in all, but I only did like 3. And we, you know, talk about, chop it up about the show. And I'm with the telling him, you know, that I'm sewing right now, getting the pieces together, but I don't know if for sure I'm gonna pull it off or not, because it's really a lot of work. But it's one of them that I'm working on right here. Yeah, the connection is horrible. That's one of them that I'm working on. And then I got a couple more to do. I'm making a top right now.
I need to be careful of my looks.
I don't even know what the fuck I'm going to wear. Like, I got to worry about all the pieces that I'm putting in the show, bitch. I don't even know what the fuck I'm going to put on. Girl.
That's good. So what? How long that's going to take?
I'ma be here all night. Y'all got like a week left, a week and a half. But I'm gonna be here all night trying to finish this shit up. Hopefully I can pull it through.
Yeah.
Sure.
Got it.
Mm-hmm. But y'all, I'll call you later, child. Let me get back to work.
All right.
My name is Quay. I'm from Atlanta, and I have a lot going on right now. So I have an underwear line, a charm bracelet line, shirts and hoodies, and I got my own dance team. I'm an actor. I sing. Hey, I feel like God gave me this talent, so I'm just trying to be a young entrepreneur. I want to do each and everything because I like money. No, I'm playing.
Hey, how's it going?
Hey, I got me here for the meeting with the agency.
Okay, cool. She's right in there. Okay.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Hey.
How are you?
Good to see you.
Good to see you too.
It's been a minute, huh?
Right. Yes, how you been?
I've been really good.
That's good.
Yeah, I'm glad that we're able to finally meet. I know that you had been popping up at a few of these auditions we've had.
I know.
And interestingly enough, we were just like, oh my God, how much has he's grown? Because right. we've known you since you were a kid.
Yeah, when y'all said that in an audition, I was like, ooh, I was young.
You were very young, yeah. So congratulations on everything that you're doing.
Thank you so much. Congratulations on the success of Dance for One.
Thank you. Tell me a little bit about your interests, what you're wanting to do.
Well, I still have my own dance team, so I have been dancing, but it's more of a majorette hip-hop type feel. And I've been acting, I've been in a couple TV shows and movies.
I saw that, yeah.
So that's what I want. I just want representation. And like, I feel like y'all family, because mm-hmm. I grew up here. So
yeah.
It's just like, why not come back, you know?
Sure.
So.
Well, the first thing that I'm gonna tell you is that we need to make sure that we get you back in classes.
Yes, of course.
Because you are really, really talented at picking up choreography mm-hmm. and staying in tune with all of that.
Right.
But I guess it's difficult when you go off and you start doing things on your own.
Yes.
Then the only thing that's training your brain and your body is what you do.
Right.
So when you really start getting out there and start auditioning for things, mm-hmm. you're expected to learn and do what they teach you.
Exactly.
So clearly you have a lot of exceptional tricks, like clearly your jumps, your acro,
right.
All of that is great,
right.
but coupled with the movement is what we need to work
exactly.
on.
Exactly.
So I think that that's the first thing that we need to do with you, Quay.
Mm-hmm.
I think we can test the waters and start sending you out on a few things here and there
right.
just to see how you do. Clearly you can act.
Thank you.
That should be pretty simple for you.
The real reason I got into that style of coaching, I've been dancing since I was younger, but my older cousin, she used to dance in the band, like majorette style. So like I was like, okay. Then when the show Bring It came out, I was like, oh wow, like look at them. So like I started mimicking everything I saw them do on the TV. I was like, I can do this. And a week later, I was just like, you know what? Like I reached out to some people. They was like, we with you if you with it. And hey, I've been doing good ever since.
Dance used to be your comfort zone too.
Yes.
And there's no doubt that you can dance.
Mm-hmm.
It's just a matter of dancing like other people.
Right.
Tell me a little bit about your dance team.
I've been with this dance team for over a year. They've competed all over. We just went against the Birmingham Dancing Dolls. We beat them. So they're growing. Before me, like they didn't have like no training or whatever. So I built them from like the ground up, to be honest. My dance team. Whew. They doing pretty good. We got a competition on the 16th in December in Mississippi, so. I am on cloud motherfucking eye. Bye-bye. So I'm really like, thank you so much. Like this is a, thank you.
I'm Tay Anthony. I'm from Detroit, Michigan. You know, I moved here to Atlanta. I do YouTube. I'm a journalist and a stylist.
It's never gonna be loud in my background, so don't be mad at me. Be mad at your God. That's what Nicki said.
When they start talking crazy, I know that they I know that I'm getting it. Cause I, when they start talking crazy, that's when I know that they
Hey, what is going on? We're back in our high society where we're all kings and queens, mostly queens, if you know what I mean. You know, I'm a queen today, child. But anyway, today we're doing a video on, we're doing a question and answer video. I know I said the next one was supposed to be with Star. I haven't met with him yet, but we're gonna still do that. We're gonna do this one too.
I go out viral numerous of times. I'm still viral right now. I'm still more viral sensation. From my memes, my clips, Nicki Minaj seeing my clips from YouTube. The Twitter girls just like love my face.
Make sure you like, subscribe, share, and comment on this video. There are going to be more videos to come. You already know if you want me to do more videos or topics, advice, anything, just let me know in the comments. I'm always watching. So do that.
I started doing YouTube just because I guess I had the personality for it and the face. Once again, the girls just thought I should be on YouTube. I really didn't think so. So I said I was gonna like ask one of my friends. But I don't like that bitch no more. Oh no no. We're cool. Mm-hmm. So I don't want to do it by myself. I'm too shy to do it by myself. So I asked my best friend, but he don't live here no more. So I'm back to square one by myself. But I'm going to keep it this way. The girls want it that way anyways.
What's going on?
What's good?
So, bitch, you know your girls been asking, bitch. Your subscribers, you know they crazy.
Oh, those crazy ass bitches.
So when you coming back?
Coming back where?
To YouTube.
YouTube. I mean, I've been around. I post a video here and there.
You know, they want us together. When are you moving together. Back?
I mean, you know, I'm coming. Tired.
Oh, girl.
Something to stay told as they always
should.
Hello.
Anything
up
their
heads is always a fire, so it's always worth it.
Of course.
Hey.
You know, we matching.
With a good nose.
You know, nose is always snatched. Always. So what's your tea? What you doing?
Yeah, I'm out. I gotta go.
Oh, we'll talk to you later.
I'm gonna be late.
Not late. All right. Never late.
You see, it's too many places for you niggas to be at the bottom. Let's see what the problem is. You pussy niggas still out here, hey? See, I ain't tripping, man. If it's by that door, I go and get it. Stacking paper to the ceiling. Why these niggas catching? I'm in the Bentley. Smoking good gas with the drop. Top 200 on the dash. Got them mad cause I won't stop.
My name is King. I'm a rapper here in Atlanta, Georgia. I'm from Atlanta. My dad's side's from Atlanta. My mom's side's from Thomaston, Georgia. I'm known for modeling and doing music. I just started taking the music seriously, but I've been doing music since I was like 8 years old. But I've just now taken it serious, so. Trying to give it a shot 100%, no more distractions. My rap name is King. I started rapping because as a little kid, I always just grew up on hip hop, like listening to Biggie, Lakim, and Tupac, and DMX. So I always just was inspired by music and fashion. So as a kid, I would write rhymes. Me and my little sister, she's like 2 years younger than me. We always say we're gonna be a rapper when we grow up. So now I'm trying to like get the opportunity to do it. So I wanna take it serious and do my best at it. Can you give me a minute right quick?
Yeah.
I'll let him.
All right,
good.
What's going on, Quay?
Hey. How are you? Yeah, you.
Me and King, we went to the same studio. I had a studio session. When I got there, he was, you know, ASAP. So I'm like, okay, this is my boy, you know, woot woot. So we got them chopping it up.
What you got going on?
Nothing, just about to record a single. What about you?
Working on my single too. I got a single coming out at the top of next year. I won't put it out this year, but I want to put like some hard time into it because it's my first project. I ain't really did no project before until now, so I really want people to fuck with me on this project.
I mean, the little snippet I heard was good. So.
Like it?
Yeah.
Like it
with it? I ain't know you real.
Yeah, I've been knowing it ever since I was a little boy, but I'm just now taking this shit serious for real, man.
That's what's up.
I want to just get my shit popping. I got a single release party next week, though, on Thursday. You come through?
Thursday? Yeah, I can.
You sure?
I'll come out to work.
I'm there.
Okay.
What been going on with you though? I seen you out on the internet going viral and shit. You and your nigga fighting. Man, what's going on?
Ex nigga. Zach. Okay, make the long story short, like, me and Zach was together or whatever, and he wanted me to move in with him. But like, the thing is, like, Zach traveled and I traveled. So it was like, it was like a hit and miss. Like, we would see each other, but we won't. And like, it was only so much FaceTime. But when Zach got back in town, I'm thinking like, we gonna be good or whatever. You know, he told me he was cheating on me. It went left.
What the fuck you doing? Like, I'll hit you with this. Like, don't touch me. I'll hit you with this. Like, I'm not playing like Karan. Stop.
Y'all broke up?
Yeah, you know, he was cheating, so.
You caught him cheating?
No, he told me.
He told you he was cheating?
Yeah, that's crazy. Like, he was talking about moving in and all that, you know. And then, I don't know, he was just like, you know, I gotta talk to you. Told me he was cheating. I thought it was for cameras, but it wasn't, so I just went off.
So you completely done with him though? Like, are y'all trying to like wreck it out? Maybe you're in a bad spot right now?
I mean, he been hit my phone, you know. You can't leave this. No, I'm playing. He didn't hit me, but I'm done. I'm completely done. That's old.
I feel you. Gotta have your respect. Respect with everything, man. But it's goddamn good. Catch up with you. Hope we got down getting in the studio soon together. I'm gonna see you next
video,
right?
We can definitely do that. I got a little love song. It's like a love freaky song. You can hop on it.
You serious?
Yeah.
I got you, man. Just got down sending shit through and coming through.
Got you.
Alright, it was good.
The night of kickback, I went to go support my friend.
Born stunt. Money.
I saw Rock. I don't know. I'm trying to remember what he had on. I definitely met up with Tay, and we had to catch up because Tay's been doing a lot of work out here in Atlanta since he like came here for college and stuff. And when I see like-minded people or somebody that's going somewhere at the young age that we are, it's like I'm drawn to them. So yeah, like we caught up and kikied.
What's up, man? How you been? I've been good. Just chilling. You know, I've just been doing like YouTube and stuff, going through.
Yeah, you've been doing good with that.
Like, for real.
We had a conversation. We talked, we just caught up. Because you know, Rock is very booked and busy. She's booked and busy. I am as well. Want to know what was going on?
So, like, what's your YouTube? What you do to YouTube?
I do reaction videos, I do challenges. Anything my subscribers want, I do it.
And it's been going good, right?
Yeah, of course.
I watched.
Girls always say, everybody doing YouTube now, but everybody can't get views. You know, I've been getting views, you know, subscribers.
And your gifts been going viral.
A viral sensation. And right. I just want to say, everybody doing YouTube. But everybody knows doing it as well as I am. Not to even sound cocky.
You said you are in front of Billy.
They're not doing it.
Yeah. Now, that's what made me move down there. Like, I moved down here for acting. And, like, it started off as acting, like I did
acting.
Okay. And then, you know, I do the radio now.
I know, I was supposed to tune in, but I haven't yet. But I watch about him.
Yeah, like when people think about gay people, they always think about fighting and drama. Like, that's not all that we are. It's a lot of us that strive in school. Some of us aren't meant for school.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, both. Everybody can't say that.
No, I don't fight no more.
But they can't say that. Oh, you talking about fighting?
I was saying I do both.
Yeah.
I don't do it no more. I'm wrong.
You don't really about that?
Not really.
But you really are, like, you've really set the bar. Like, you do things that people always don't do. And it's not common.
Really?
Yeah. And it's, I'm actually talking to you. It's really weird, but I'm
talking
to you.
Oh my god, don't say that.
Like, you do stuff that's not common.
Thank you so much.
You set the bar, say for real.
I don't know.
Like, you're coming up
in. When do y'all,
your radio like show broadcast and stuff?
I do it on Tuesdays, Tuesday nights, 7 to 9.
Did you already see the exit game?
Saturday mornings, 11 to 3.
Okay.
I got two different shows. My favorite show is on Tuesday.
So yeah, we're gonna go back to the party.
We're gonna have to. It's time to get me.
I'm at the party, having a good time. You know, standing next to Rob, we talking or whatever. And this guy texts me. I had got his number a couple days ago, and he asked me to be the face of his brand or whatever. And you know, I'm like, I don't know. I was kind of like, for what? I really don't even know you. You don't know me. So he was like, I can show you a couple sketches. I was like hesitant. He was like, okay, let's meet up. I'm like, he says he's gonna make me some underwear. You gonna do what?
But he said some guy that he was working with was like being on like the creepy side, which I'm used to that. Like I'm used to hearing about that because even in the acting business, everybody just wants to sleep with everybody. So, yeah.
I think he's trying to do business because I'm good for business, but I'm also good for pleasure. So I don't know, but he needs to know he's not getting anything. But what he asked for is the face.
No, seriously.
He's in somebody else's car or he's in your car. When I see him, it's gonna be a problem. Like, I swear on everything I love, it's gonna be a problem. I don't give a fuck about all that. This nigga is in the car with somebody else. Like, I'm not at this party. You tripping. Like, I would drag you and that bitch. Do you not understand where I'm coming from? He's being corny as fuck. That's a fuckboy move right there. Damn, at least make sure I'm not there when you do shit like that. Bitch, you doing it while I'm there. Ain't nobody gonna sit in the car by themselves this whole time. You tripping. Am I right, woman? Am I right? Ain't nobody gonna sit in this. Exactly. I'm sorry, but they got me stressing right now. I'm missing Kwan. Where you at?
I'm in the house.
This Zion? Yeah. Zion, where the fuck is he at? What you call it? Yeah.
I don't know.
Next time on the Come Up Atlanta.
Hold them. Okay, I did not know them. What are you talking about? Okay, nigga, you'll fight somebody to fuck over here.
Stop.
This is so crazy right now.
Oh, you good.
What's going on with Timmy and Darian Lee's name?
Who the fuck is this bitch talking to?
I'm having a single release party soon. I want you to come out and show love. It's gonna be lit.
Oh yeah, of course. I wouldn't miss that. Oh no, I'm gonna do that.
Oh, you don't?
Nah. But nah, I'm having a house party too. You should come through.
So I heard Miss T. Anthony was saying something about you being dressed, bro.
I don't care because I know I can dress.
So you think it's
going to
be awkward the next time y'all see each other?
Look how she dressed.
Right. Tonight is my single release party. I'm so excited, man. I've been waiting so long to showcase my music.
All for coming out tonight, showing love to me, especially you, Quay, for being in the studio with me, helping me out. Thank you for going to the radio station.
At the motherfucking listening party, Tay walked in, Timmy and Darion start whispering. Tay told Rock, he said, come here. I don't want you standing over there.
Shout out to all y'all.
I work with Amber H. I work with Glow Princess.
This is about to go down.
This is a fake. Trust me, this is a fake. Actually, get a career.
Yeah, cause didn't you wear that jacket the other day?
I will smack that bitch. She already knows.
I'm working with the girl Brittany Taylor from Off of Love and Hip Hop New York.
This celebrity.
Okay.
We need more love in the air, more positivity.
This is the car. come up. Like, we all struggling, but we're still trying to come up. Other niggas?
I can't just cut them off. Like, it's not that simple.
Come on.
I can't do the camera. Oh, what? I can't, like, stop. I can't do this. It's too much.
How you sleep?
Good.
It's good.
Me too.
Yeah, I never did no shit like this before, so it's like, I really came out here just for you.
Where was you last night?
Busy.
Busy doing what?
I don't know if you know, but my son Tate, he kind of made out with your niece.
Come on. Little Bird told me
that
you kissing people at the porn.
What's up? Basically, Chris is cheating on you with 3 different people and a porn star, so I just thought you should know.
Okay, nigga, you'll fight somebody to fuck on me!
You know what?
That's her talk. Stay back.